Hi, this is Aileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about preparing and running a simulation in Magix using the simulation module. The simulation module creates virtual prototypes of your parts so that you can visualize build risks. Based on this information, you can make the necessary modifications to increase build and part quality before actually building the part, and as such avoid wasting valuable time and money. The simulation module is easy to use, fast, and doesn't require simulation expertise. Moreover, you can run all your simulation related operations without even leaving Magix. The first thing you need is a build platform. If you'd like to learn more about build preparation, please see our tutorials on preparing a build in Magix. Here, we have a build platform that's ready to be simulated. We'll go to the Simulation tab and click on Simulation. On the new window, we can define a job name, let's call it Simulation 1, and a save directory. First, we will enable the simulation types we would like to do, and the calibration profiles to be used. If you'd like to learn more about calibration for the simulation module, please see our tutorial on calibration for simulation. To do mechanical simulation, enable the option. If you would like to check or modify your calibration profile, you can click on the pen icon and the calibration menu window will pop up. If you enable generate compensated part, a new version of the part that compensates for the calculated deformations will be created. In this process, the part is remodified and resimulated until the best compensating fit is found. To do thermal simulation, enable the option. If you would like to check or modify your calibration profile, you can click on the pen icon and the calibration menu window will pop up. You will also need to define your base plate height and temperature. Finally, define your voxel size. Voxels are three-dimensional volume units that represent your part during simulation calculations. Voxel size determines the expected error margin for your calculations and should be chosen relative to the part size. For quick feedback on deformation tendencies, you can choose a larger voxel size. For more accurate results, you can choose a smaller voxel size. However, please note that the smaller the voxel size, the longer the calculation will take. With uniform voxel size, cubic voxels will be created. Alternatively, you can use non-uniform voxelization proportional to the aspect ratio of your part. For example, you can create long voxels if you have a tall part. If you click on Calculate Preview, you can see a preview of the voxelization. Once you click on OK, your simulation job will be automatically placed in the Job Manager, and the Job Manager will open. A simulation job consists of sub-elements. Here we have the mechanical simulation, the compensated part calculation, and the thermal simulation because we enabled these options. Let's select our simulation job and click on Run to start it. Please note that you can minimize the Job Manager window during the calculations and just continue using Magix without interruptions. Simulation jobs will continue running in the background and you will receive a notification as soon as they are finished. Now that our simulation job is complete, we are ready to analyze the simulation results. If you'd like to learn more about analyzing simulation results and modifying your build platform based on these results, please see our tutorial on analyzing simulation results. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.